Today we're going to listen to a story called Our Class is a Family. It's written by Shannon Olson. She's the one who wrote the story. She's the author. And it's illustrated by Sandy Sonke. Illustrated means she's the one who drew the pictures in the story. Our class is a family. When you think of a family, you might picture one in a house. A mom, a dad, a couple of kids, plus their dogs, and a pet mouse. Perhaps you think of grandma, or a stepmom and stepdad. It could be those 14 cousins, or that twin that makes you mad. But family doesn't have to be who you're related to. It could be another special group who love and care for you. Have you ever thought about where most of your time is spent? It's at school with all of us. That's where all those hours went. So, if our classroom is the place where we spend our days, why wouldn't we want to make it like a home in many ways? It's a place where we can show respect and kindness to each other, a spot where we can be ourselves and make memories with one another. We'll have things in common. These are connections that we'll seek, but we'll still celebrate our differences and what makes us each unique. Our classroom is a special haven where it's okay to make mistakes. We learn from them and try again, no matter what it takes. We'll all have tough days sometimes, but your teacher is here for you. And as long as you're a friend to others, your peers will be there too. In this classroom of four walls, we will stick together. We'll help each other learn and grow in any kind of weather. So let's always remember what a great team we can be. You have our back and we have yours. We're a classroom family. And that's the end of our story. Remember, we are always a family, even though we're far away from each other right now. And we may not be in the walls of our classroom, but we are still a family, and I am still here for you, and we are all still here for each other.